forecast.
Haven't heard any solid evidence of any slowdown. Mike Murphy, we're talking about 4% economic growth and all these predictions of, you know, things are going to slow down so much in the next 2 years. I'm just trying to get my head around it. I don't understand how that happens when you're in this period just because of higher interest rates. What's causing the slowdown?
I don't think there's much to get your head around because I don't see it either. So you talk about rates going higher, but it's not rates going higher by 25 basis points every quarter, say. That's not enough to grind this growth to a halt.
Right.
This isn't, so we don't have growth that can't be even surpassed next year. So I think a lot of this is pouring water on an economy. I think a lot of it comes from people expecting 2% growth and getting used to 2% growth, now seeing 4% growth and saying this can't be sustainable. But I think it actually is. I don't see anything out there either.
Yeah, let me ask Mark Bomnardelli a question.
So the reason they're saying this is that they're excluding facts. So let's just go over the facts. First thing is first is we are now in higher levels of debt than 2008. So that means the average consumer in the U.S. economy is carrying more debt before the economic crash. So you can get to 4% for, you know, these last two quarters because you did massive tax cuts that gave money to people, which it's not going to happen again. It's the tax cuts that Trump gave us, they all expire. And in fact, if you make less than, I believe, $80,000, your taxes are going to go up over time. So once again, it's like you cannot expect to have 4% growth if more people are getting in debt. And the interest rates do make a big difference because the problem is if you're in debt and your interest rate goes up, that means your cost of debt is going up. And that's why the real estate market is not going to go up anymore, because if I bought a house and my rate is 3% and then all of a sudden it goes up to 4%, that means my interest has gone up 33%. My payment on my mortgage is going to go up 33%. And guess what? A lot of people buy homes on adjustable mortgages. So that means the rate will reset to a much higher rate. And guess what? They can't afford it. Oh, in the meantime, their taxes just went up as well. So yes, this is a great policy. Trump's policy is great for short term, and it's smart of him. As a politician, he's not going to care once it's 2020 and he's in office. It doesn't matter. He's been elected, and that's the problem with our election cycles, is he cares about this election cycle to make sure that Republicans don't lose the House, and he's concerned about 2020 because he wants to get reelected. So he passed a bunch of policies that are front loaded, and this is why, like, the smarter economists are saying, hey, like, this is not sustainable. And Fox doesn't really bring up the point that, you know, people are more in debt, wages haven't gone up, and they keep using jobs, but you have to realize these jobs are bad jobs. These are like $11 an hour jobs. And to be honest, it's not Trump's fault. This is actually starts with Obama. So when the recession happened, Obama was creating jobs, but the jobs Obama was bringing in is very similar to Trump. And what's really interesting is Trump identifies all this when he's running as a candidate. And that's why, you know, for me, I agreed with candidate Trump. I mean, he brought up a lot of good stuff. And what's unfortunate is he's a businessman. He got into power and Trump is taking care of Trump. And so he's doing things that are smart for Trump. And I don't think it's good for the economy long term. I could be wrong, like I said, but please, you know, bring me some facts, because this 4% growth is great. I'm not taking that away from Trump, but he did it by increasing our spending, which he ripped Obama for. And I guess Trump is actually helping me, because he's going to make real estate cheaper, which I do plan on buying the dip when real estate prices go down. And I do feel like he's helping crypto go up. So as a cryptocurrency investor, short term, crypto's not going to be an attractive asset class because Trump doesn't want the stock market to crash until he gets elected. But long term, when that stock market crash happens, Trump's helping all of us crypto investors. So don't hate on Trump too much, because he's actually good for your pocketbook if you're a crypto investor. But let me know your thoughts and I will talk to you soon.